Hello students, today we discuss about the basic principles and terminology of PTC. This one is the plant tissue culture. So today we talk about what is the plant tissue culture and which type of terms can be used in the plant tissue culture. This one is a broad subject in the BSc Biotechnology semester 5 and semester 2. Introduction. What is plant tissue culture? The growth or regeneration of plant cells, tissues, organ or whole plant in artificial medium under aseptic condition. So in the plant tissue culture, we try to grow the plant from the artificial medium in the aseptic condition. So in the laboratory, we can use the plant cells, tissues, organ and some other part of the plant which is the living part, and they parts can be inoculated into the artificial medium under aseptic condition. That whole study or the process is known as the plant tissue culture. These are the numerous methods to propagate plant in the tissue culture. So in the tissue culture, different type of methods are included to do the tissue culture, just like cell culture, callus culture, protoplast culture, anther culture, embryo culture. These are the different type of methods or the cultures. But the one principle that is contained is totipotency. All plants and plant parts have this potential. So that totipotency is the concept. And in this concept, what's happened? The plant cells can be redifferentiate and again redifferentiate and become the plant. So in the simply, a one cell is equal to one plant. So from the one cell we can grow the whole plant, and that phenomena and that ability is known as the totipotency. Why does tissue culture work? Totipotency, the ability of a cell to differentiate and develop into the whole plant when given the correct conditions. This is because every cell has the genetic potential of the parent plants. So this means what? That is a phenomena, and that phenomena is what? That is the ability of the cell to differentiate and develop the whole plant. Why a cell is developed? Because the all genetic potentially are in the plant cells, and they have regenerate, they have automatically switch on in the different type of the condition. So that condition is the lab condition. In the aseptic condition, in the lab condition, in the artificial medium, the cell are in the stress, and they have differentiate into the whole part, and they differentiate into the callus, and that callus again regenerate into the whole plants. So that phenomena is under in the totipotency. So exactly what the totipotency? A plant cells or the tissues. The tissues become into the callus. That callus is again regenerated into the plant organs or embryo, or a new plant can be regenerated. So that the plant cells, and that plant cells is inoculate into the artificial medium, and that become the callus. So that callus is a differentiate or really differentiate or into the plant organs, and that plant's organ is become the embryo, and that embryo is regenerate and become a new plant. So that is the concept of the totipotency, or a whole concept is the plant tissue culture. Some terms, the explant. Explant is the living tissues transferred from a plant into an artificial medium for callus. So when become the callus culture, a small part of the plant we can transfer into the artificial medium, and that small part is known as a callus. It can be any portions of the shoot, leaf, root, flower and cell from the plant. So any plant or any part which is a living part, that is known as the explant. Again, next term is in vitro culture. In vitro means in the tube, in the glass. So in the tube or in the glass, we can regenerate the plants, and that is known as the in vitro culture. So the culture which is grow into the tubes, that is known as the in vitro culture. So all type of culture including animal cells, in vitro fertilization is an example of the in vitro culture. Tissue culture. These terms is growth of the cells and the tissue in the sterile environment. So in the lab condition, when the cell or tissue is grow, that is known as the tissue culture. Undifferentiated plant cells, plant callus, plant tissues, these are the example of the growth. Next one is the micropropagation. The micropropagation is the process where we grow the plant into the lab. So when not into the lab, we grow the plant, that is known as the propagation. So the simply in the field, we grow the seed and the crops can be ready, that is known as the propagation. But micropropagation means what? The small part of the plant, that is the explant, we can use and we produce the plant. So that is process is known as the micropropagation. The production of whole plant from a small section of a plant, that is known as the explant, just like the apical bud, axillary bud, meristemic cell. So these all are the explant, and from the explant the whole plant is grow in the lab, that comes known as the micropropagation. So the micropropagation is commercially available in the lab in the Gujarat. Most of the different type of the labs are there and they grow the banana. So in the Gujarat, the banana cultivation or banana tissue culture plant is very famous in the India. Nowadays, the tissue culture, in vitro culture and micropropagations are sometimes used, are interchangeable. So we can use the both of terms, in vitro culture or micropropagation. So both are the same. In vitro culture of the banana and micropropagation of the banana is the same techniques in the plant tissue culture. These are the very important some terms: differentiation, de-differentiation, redifferentiation and undifferentiation. So these all four terms we can explain with the graph or with the photograph.